Hello.
Here we go. How about that trombone section? One more big hand. Teachers in the world. Now they're going to go sit down. Seventh graders, thank you for joining us. You can head on out. And we're going to get going with our next selection called the Cartoon Symphony. You're going to hear a little bit of the Jetsons and the Simpsons and the Flintstones and
thank you.
Thank you so much. The big eighth grader here is my wife. She's subbing for our first chair flute. He's on an airplane right now somewhere toward Europe. Iggy, you heard him last night. Great, great player. And so I said, you gotta hire a sub. And the look on his face was like, what is that you're saying? It's so funny. You gotta hire a sub. So he hired a sub. So and for those of you that don't know my wife, she not only plays the flute, obviously. She's one of our elementary music teachers in the district. Yes. Our next selection, I believe, is called Drums Olé, which features the saxophones. I'm just kidding. Features the drums. Drums Olé. Next year. marching band, jazz ensemble, wind ensemble, drum line. There's all sorts of things you can do in high school. And I joked about this last night. They sound good, but nobody ever goes, yeah, I peaked when I was in eighth grade. That was my peak. You laugh because we're going, yeah, that wasn't my peak. So the point is as good as they've gotten, imagine what will happen if they join one of those programs and continue on. And as I mentioned before, I have no idea. My mom just said, whatever you want to do, I picked music. And she supported me. I was a single parent family. We were poor. I don't know how she bought that cruddy trumpet I had. But she got me lessons, and next thing you know, I'm doing this all these years. And you know, all the trips to Europe and Disneyland and SeaWorld. Yeah. So that doesn't happen if they don't sign up to play in high school. So make sure you guys are aware of that. They also need a arts credit, fine arts credit. Okay? I've seen some of them draw. You should definitely be a band. Okay? All right. Thank you. Our next piece is a piece entitled Bach to the Future. Bach is the key word here, folks. Bach. You guys heard of Bach? We're talking about Johann Sebastian Bach, yes. He died a long time ago. I'm sure you heard about it. It's on social media. But he's one of the great composers of all time. So you'll recognize the melody. It starts off with a really cool flute and low brass rendition back there. And then it goes into a rock feel with our friend Henry back there on the drums. Let's stand up, Henry, so they can see. Give him a wave. That's Henry, everybody. All right, so let's play Bach to the Future. Thank you. Alrighty, alrighty, alrighty. Have we eaten all the food yet? Jen, is there any food left? She's looking. A little food left? Got a special deal for you here, full price. That means buy one for six and get one for six. For you math wizards, that's pretty good, huh? Yeah. We're gonna do another piece now. This is called Carol of the Bells / Greensleeves. So it's a compilation arranged by Mr. Larry Clark, and it's quite difficult. Like, if you looked at like the flute part, you would go, whoa. Okay, so this is definitely a step up. That Bakhtinda Feature is a piece we've been working on since maybe September, right? Early in the year. This one we've been working on maybe a month. Hopefully you won't be able to tell. Carol of the Bells / Greensleeves. We have to be honest with them, right? And But I am honest and sincere when I say I'm really proud of the hard work they put in. And you notice they're learning things like the timpani's back there tuning right now, which is what they're supposed to be doing while I talk. That's why I talk, so the timpani can tune. I don't know what happens when the timpani's not playing. So our last piece is called a holiday extravaganza. So whatever holiday you celebrate, we've got Hanukkah and Kwanzaa and Christmas all wrapped into one. This is by a gentleman named David Bobrovitz. Thank you for being a great audience. At the conclusion of this piece, we're going to be selling Mexican food for at cost. As long as you laugh, I'm going to keep going. I hope you guys all have a happy holiday season. What we're going to need to do is all these brown chairs here, we're going to save about 70 of them. All the gray ones over here, we're not going to save any of them. We're going to fold them up, and you know where? I think we probably better put them, up here, but we have to put them in the racks. Is our custodian here by any chance? Is he here, Ms. Vega? Yeah, because I want to help get everything put away so he's not here all night. What the jazz parents are going to do for the next half hour after we're done is set up chairs, tables, clean this whole area up while we set up the stage, and hopefully we can get out of here in about 30 minutes. It takes about that. And then all the jazz band kids are going to be here on stage starting at 7 o'clock tomorrow morning, 7, 8 p.m. We start playing at 7 a.m., so they should probably get here at 6:45. I'll get here at 6:30, how's that? Okay, once again, have a happy holiday season. Thank you for sharing these children with me and all the teachers. And once again, this is called Holiday Extravaganza. Thank you so much. Thank you.